That is my weakness, and I am not quite patient with my winning trades. That is what's happening, guys. So I need to sit down and talk to myself about what is happening. So I need to adjust it. I need to come up with a kind of solution for myself. I need to sort it. It is not going to work. I entered nice trades, right entry, right direction, right spot, but don't stick to that. That is not gonna work. Guys, I placed 6 trades on silver. I hope it works. If it doesn't, I will give up all my wins. Whoa, it's getting a bit difficult. Oh, it's going against my direction, guys. So far, I gave up all I gained.
Senate Majority Leader McConnell says we do need another COVID aid package. We're 10 minutes away from the release of US wholesale inventories. This is a final reading for August, month on month, seen at spot 5% against the price, spot 5%. We also get wholesale trade sales month on month for August, seen rising by 2% against a prior 4.6%. We also expect to hear from the UK Chancellor, Rishi Sunak. He was interviewed by the broadcast poll earlier today, and this will be released at 3 p.m. on Sky News. tweet here from Erica Werner from the Washington Post. Says new stimulus deal unlikely in the next 3 weeks. That's McConnell speaking at an event. McConnell says airline aid should be part of any COVID package. It's unclear though whether a standalone bill could pass. And more from Erica Werner via Twitter, says McConnell reiterates he hasn't seen Trump in person since August, but they speak almost every day. Just repeat that first tweet from Erica Werner. She's a reporter for the Washington Post, quoting Senate Majority Leader McConnell, who says a new stimulus deal is unlikely in the next 3 weeks. More from McConnell, says there's widespread agreement that airlines need aid. Meanwhile, in geopolitics, the United States said to see some progress on the Russia talks for a nuclear freeze. And McConnell says an airline-only bill is unlikely as the election nears. And 3 minutes now till data. US wholesale inventories month on month for August seen at spot 5%, unchanged from the flash print. Wholesale trade sales seen rising by 2% in August. Also possible comments from the UK Chancellor, expected to speak on Sky News. 1 minute. Seconds. Spot 4% for wholesale inventories, 1 spot 4% for wholesale trade sales. The UK is expanding their wage support for firms that have been told to close due to the coronavirus. UK government announces they're to pay 2/3 of employee salaries. Cash grants for firms have been raised up to £3,000 a month. This will begin on the 1st of November and will run for 6 months thereafter. UK expanding wage support here for firms that have been told to close due to the coronavirus. Chancellor is expected to speak now, or is speaking now in fact, on Sky News. Also worth reminding, US President Trump will be hosting the Rush Limbaugh radio show today. It's now been announced this will take place at noon today. We assume that's Eastern time, so 5 p.m. London time. We'll double check on the timing. We do expect to hear from US House Speaker Pelosi. She's scheduled to speak at 15 minutes past the hour, so just under 5 minutes. She will be speaking alongside Representative Raskin on the introduction of legislation to establish a commission on presidential capacity. This is better known as the 25th Amendment. US House Speaker Pelosi says the presidential capacity bill is not about the president.
All right, guys, I did a very, very large gamble, guys, and I survived.
We're 10 minutes away from the bottom.
I just survived, guys.
Chief Economist Andrew
Kildane, just survived
at an event at the OECD titled New Analytical Approaches and the Coronavirus. The discussion is alongside two other speakers, begins at 3:30 London time and lasts for an hour. No indication of a prepared text from Haldane.
I took large gamble, guys, and it paid off somehow, and up to now I survived. I was in 30% of now, 30% of loss. 30%? Maybe 20% of loss. I was in 20% of loss, guys, in a point, and now I am in, I think, 4% of profit. 25. Okay, I will count it late. Let me see if I can sell again on this market. Is it going to go down or not? If it goes up, I will give up all the gain. Going to go up again, guys. Going to go up again. Same story up to now. Same story.
According to the New York Times, two more White House resident staff members have now tested positive for the coronavirus. And in election news, the Washington Post reporting a US judge has denied the request to extend the voter registration in Florida.
Okay guys, I took massive risk. I don't know how many trades I had. I don't know how many trades guys I had. I will show you what I did. I think I had at least 300 trades maybe. These are the trades guys. These are the trades. And I am almost 5% up on my account. These are the trades. And massive risk guys. Massive risk guys. Massive risk. £40. Let me see. How much is this? Yes, guys, 7% on the account up to now. Now it's going to my direction. Did you see what happened? Guys, did you actually see what I did? Did you see? So, how many trades I had? Let me see how many trades I had today, guys. God knows. God knows. God knows. Okay, I have had, guys, I have had 222 trades. 222 trades, guys. 200 is front of your eyes here. Today, 222 trades, 162 winners, 59 losers, and 7% on the account, which is quite enough for me. As I mean, it was just a Friday, in a Friday, that is fantastic. 7% on the account. on 222 trades, guys. It's not a joke. I hope you enjoyed that, guys. If you enjoyed that, give it a like, and I really, really appreciate that. Thank you, guys. Thank you very, very much.